ignoring me again. I thought we fixed this yesterday. Fine.
Miss Minyas, the interior. Good evening, Miss Minyas. How are you feeling today?
I'm fine, I guess. I'm just quite shaky still, is all.
What did you say was your connection to Miss Minyas?
Well, we're colleagues. I'm a mental health nurse and I usually work with her. No, to be quite honest, it almost feels like I'm more of a servant. Always running around doing her room, and she's never satisfied either.
It says here that you were the one who found the body. Can you tell us what happened?
Yeah. I did a late shift that night. Not with her. I was helping out Dr. Taylor with a patient that wouldn't take the drugs. Four of us were coming down. And she's not with that.
Returns for the victim, were you?
No, listen, alright. I didn't like her. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. What's the point of suddenly loving her now that she's dead? I hate that hypocrisy. Everyone suddenly forgetting all the shit she's done to people just because they're afraid of coming off as horrible or of being arrested or something. I'm not like that. I mean, I didn't kill her. There's a huge leap between not liking someone and wanting them dead, but I'm gonna say that she was not nice. She was horrible, horrible, I'm telling you, to Harvey, her husband, that is. And he's such a lovely person. He deserves so much better. But I remember one time I got so cross at her.
Busy day?
Yeah, actually. Can't wait for it to be over.
I thought you must be busy, because, you know I asked you to check on the patient in room 301?
Yeah.
Change his meds?
Yeah.
I went back about 15 minutes ago and you hadn't done it?
Yeah, but you know, that's because I did it like 5 minutes ago. He asked me to do three things at the same time and then I haven't quite mastered the gift of ubiquity yet. So,
as long as it's done.
Yeah, it's done now. just chill at home, I think. Read, maybe catch up on TV shows again.
No overtime then?
No, not today.
Hey, you're up?
Hiya!
Thanks so much. See you, sure?
Oh, thanks.
Right, Dan, got your milkshake if you want it.
Oh, thank you, such a babe.
Yeah, sorry, I've already eaten.
Okay.
I'm not feeling sushi anyway. My lunch break's over, I better go.
Right then. I'll see you later.
Do you and Mr. Winter have a romantic connection?
No. Oh, Jesus Christ, no. We're just really close friends. He's like a brother to me. I mean, I'm quite protective of him, which is why it might come across as if there are some feelings involved, but I would never go there. And he's not really my type anyway. Could I go now? It's quite late, and I still have to go into work tomorrow.
Thank you, Miss Lydia.
Oh my god, Mickey, thank god you came.
What the hell is going on?
I think you should sit down. I don't know how to tell you this. It's Anna.
You don't mean... Oh my god.
Shaney Evans, the interviewer, please. Hello, Miss Evans. Could you tell us about your relationship with Mrs. Winter?
Anna and I met at university. We both studied psychology and we lived near each other in student accommodation. So we had quite a lot of fun. We used to go to lectures together and we'd help each other with our assignments. Well, I'd help her whenever she needed. I mean, which wasn't often, she was brilliant. But then whenever I needed help, she was always too busy.
Is your relationship ever strained at all?
I suppose you could say we had our ups and downs, but every friendship does, right? I don't know. Maybe she could have been more supportive.
After I've earned some money, you know.
Oh, okay. But what about, like, the experience?
I mean, yeah, but...
shared a flat together while she was doing her PhD and when I worked full time at the clothes shop. But then when she graduated, she moved out. And that left me struggling a little bit. But I got by okay. We worked quite as close after that day.
When did you last see, Spencer?
Last see her? Last week at the shops, maybe? We didn't stop and chat. We were both in a bit of a rush. I rang her this afternoon, though. I just got the worst news. I lost my job. They made redundant. I rang her just to see if she could meet me and help calm me down and remind me of all the good times we had at university. She blew me off. She didn't ask what was so urgent or why I was so upset. Maybe she wasn't such a good friend after all.
Thank you, Sanders.
Tim?
I'm sure.
Hey, what are you doing here?
It's a waiting room. I'm waiting.
but how did you know Anna?
Charlie Winter and Anna Winter. Why didn't she use her married name?
I don't know. I'm her sister.
Oh. Anna was my counselor.
Oh.
Mr. Lockhart's to the interior, please. Being Mr. Lockhart's to the interior.
Sorry, I'm not exactly sure what I'm doing here. Like, obviously I understand the situation, but I was only a patient. I'm not sure what I can tell you.
It's exactly the reason we asked you to come in. Previous interviews indicate you may have been the last person to see Anna alive.
That's possible, I suppose. Our last session was 6:30 on a Thursday evening, as it usually is. My little question. Sorry, if you're going to question me, maybe I should have a light present.
We'll have to stop this interview and wait for them to arrive. It may take some time, and as you'd expect, time is of the essence.
No, of course. Go on, proceed.
In your own words, can you discuss your relationship with the deceased?
Anna was my counsellor. I'm not particularly fond of the word therapist. It's a bit on the clinical side, don't you think? We met twice a week, and our sessions usually involve coping mechanisms or just having conversations. She tends to be a lot friendlier than people I've seen in the past, and it's just... Sorry, I saw Anna twice a week in about 2 years now.
You indicated you liked Anna's more personal approach. It's unusual for a psychotherapist to be personal with their patients. Would you therefore say that your relationship with Anna became unprofessional at any point?
Not professional per se. It was just that she wasn't particularly condescending or judgmental. To be quite honest, Anna never really made me feel broken. Well, at least not most of the time. So anyway, and then Burns hands back our litigation lectures, and I got them too.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
And it's good, but the thing is, remember a few weeks back when I wasn't doing so well?
Yeah.
I had a talk presentation and I think I got 49 in it.
Oh.
So I'm worried about how like averages and stuff will work out.
I mean, a 49 isn't that bad, so providing it's only the one, it should be okay. a couple of weeks ago, you mentioned the Charlotte?
Charlie? I mean, I think she got a 58.
That's not what I'm talking about, and you know it.
No, I mean, we've been texting back and forth, but it's, yeah, no. We'll see where it goes.
Well, I'm glad you've had a good week, actually, because there's something I need to talk to you about.
So.
It's possible that
months, I will be taking a step back.
Like you'll be leaving?
Not leaving per se, more like taking a leave of absence.
Okay, but it's a leave of absence. Leaving is in the title, and leaving is what you're gonna do.
I'm very sorry. It's for a personal reason. You'll be transferred to a fantastic doctor.
I don't care if it's cats or it's Freud or it's God! I chose you as my therapist because I trust you, and you throw that in my face! Do you think I like sitting here and making myself seem mad and crazy and paranoid?
I'm very sorry, and I'm...
But that's the thing! You are sorry! You don't care how I feel in all of this! I'm just some broken little boy you can plaster with sunshine and rainbows! You know you actually don't give a fuck about someone else for once!
You may say it got a little too personal to be professional at times. But Anna was my friend. And she wanted to leave, or abandon me, or do something. And I wasn't okay. I'm not okay with that, and I'm not okay with this, and I'm done. I'm sorry.
Hey, Ed.
Mr. Ashford, to the interior room, please. Mr. Ashford, I'm sorry to bring you in under these circumstances.
I'm sorry. I don't think I can do this. I can't be caught me.
We understand your reservations, but this interview is taking place so that we can resolve this case as quickly as possible. We need to ask you a few questions.
She was my everything. My world. Beautiful, intelligent, funny, in that weird way that only I understood. I only saw her at lunch. How could this happen?
How did you meet your wife?
It's a funny story, actually. You know, I saw her three times in one day. I never really believed in fate until I met Anna. First time I was at the supermarket. I was getting some lunch. The second, by the zebra crossing boy here at school. And the third, was that night at the bar. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I'm so, so sorry. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. Are you okay?
Are you okay?
I will be fine. Your dress, I am so sorry.
It's okay, sit down.
Oh my god. Are you okay? I'm so sorry.
It's fine.
Have I seen you today, Manisha?
I don't think so. I'm Anna.
Hi, I'm Harvey.
Nice to meet you.
So, what brings you here then?
Oh. One of my colleagues from work. It's his leaving party. I was sort of dragged out, actually.
Alright. What is it you do?
I'm a psychotherapist.
Oh, okay. Read my mind. Should I go? Sorry.
It doesn't quite work like that. Well, but maybe if I spent enough time around you, I could give it a go.
To
the pub.
Just watching the game with a couple of friends, really, not much.
Oh, fair enough.
Okay, can I be really forward? Do you have a boyfriend by any chance?
No, not a boyfriend.
Cool. Seeing as I. Yeah. Can I buy you a drink?
Sure, okay.
Cool, I'll be right back.
You've been informed that your relationship with Miss Simpson was not the healthiest. Please explain.
That's not true. Well, we've been fighting. It got quite bad. She's slept with her sister last night. She wasn't listening to me. I just get the feeling she's not in it as I am. Bet she was not that with Nikki. She can't get enough of her. Still rather text her than talk to me. Look, she wasn't perfect. But neither am I. No one is. Everything I said sounds worse than it is. I love her. She made my dreams a reality.
Did you know she was pregnant?
Check this guy out.
What the hell is he wearing? What's going on with his hair?
Well,
like,
I guess you probably want to wait for Harvey to tell him, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
When are you going to tell him about the baby?
I just need more time.
I'm just saying, like, if it were me, I'd want to know.
I can't tell him because as soon as I tell him, it becomes real, and then I have to tell the people at work, and then I have to think about what I'm going to do when I'm leaving, and then there's baby showers and pram buying, and I just...
Anna, I don't get it. That sounds great. Surely you want people to know.
I'm just not ready yet.
Right. It's none of my business.
Miss Green, into the interview room, please.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't want to be here. Why am I here anyway? It's not like you called me in. I came because of Charlie. You know, my best friend, my housemate. It's kind of weird because I knew Anna longer, but I always feel like I got on better with Charlie than I ever did that. She gets me.
How was your relationship with Anna?
Fine. It was fine. I mean, I loved her. I thought she was incredible. I think she still is incredible in her own way, but, you know, she did cheat on me, so that kind of puts a dampener on your relationship. Plus, she left me for Mr. Boring, too. I mean, I thought she had good taste, but I guess not. And she would tell Miss Hatching that she was pregnant, so what does that say about them? Okay, maybe things have been a little strange since we broke up, but what breakup isn't like that? At least we have Charlie to smooth things over between us.
What's it like being around Anna so often because of Charlie?
I can deal with it, okay? I'm not a delicate little flower. I mean, sure it's awkward when we live together, and Anna comes round and she feels like she's just welcome, and I want to tell her that she's not welcome. She wasn't great with Charlie and she certainly fucked me over, but she just barges in like no big deal.
Hey, hey, sister!
Hey, girl!
How was
your day?
Exhausting, but pretty good, actually.
Yeah? What happened?
I talked to that boy, like.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was like the end of the lecture. We just been messaging, but I finally spoke to him. He's really quiet though, like, quite reserved. I don't know why. Maybe I should ask him out.
Yeah, go for it. Why not?
Yeah? Do you think?
Absolutely.
Alright, yeah, I will, yeah. Hiya! Oh, hey! should always wait for them to come to you. You don't seem to be keen. What do you think?
Well, I mean, she has got a point.
Okay.
Maybe I still love her. She was my everything, you know. I miss what we had together sometimes. Look, can we move on from this? I really don't want to talk about this anymore.
Where were you between the hours 4 and 6?
I don't know. I went and got a loaf of bread. Is that illegal now? Clearly it is, since you've called me in here. What would have happened if I bought those donuts I was eyeing up? Ooh, scandalous. Yeah, I went for a walk for like half an hour. Clearly that's illegal now too. Look, I'm done here. I don't want to talk to you anymore. Come on, let's go. I told him I was leaving.
I've never seen anyone so aggressive.
I'm just some broken little boy that you can plaster over in rainbows and sunshine instead of giving a fuck about someone else for once.
After calming myself down and collecting my thoughts, I did what I normally do. I collected my things together, and I left. I always leave via the back steps, because that way you avoid the rush. It was when I got to